So I have already run for this particular building, so I am directly opening that model which is run already to directly show you the results. So let me open that model. So if I will, after running the analysis, I'll go to display, and this is the option static pushover curve. It will directly give me the, show me the pushover curve. So here you can see that this is a graph between base shear on y-axis and monitor displacement, which is the displacement of my roof node on x-axis. Currently I have seen that this is in negative direction. Actually it means that the pushover load case have pushed it towards left hand side, right? So if I give minus 1 as the scale factor, my pushover curve will be on the right hand side, right? The same pushover curve will be on the right hand side. So you can also manually convert it in positive. You can just multiply this x-axis with minus 1, you will get a curve on the right hand side. So it is actually the same pushover curve, but the monitor displacement was in negative, right? So you can guess that minus sign simply means towards right hand side or towards left hand side, pushing towards right hand side or pushing towards left hand side. So if I want, this is for mode 1 push, right? Mode 1 push in x direction. So this is an example result. You can manually convert it into right hand side also, or you can just play with different other features. If you want to get the values, because you can see here the points on that pushover curve, the cursor is actually showing, giving you the coordinates. You can click on this option, formatted. You can see the table which shows the base shear versus roof displacement graph. The table actually, which you can copy and take it in Excel and plot it yourself. You can also develop summary reports. So you can see here that this table is being populated. So all of these points are actually the pushover cases. Actually, I just push it up till 26 or in fact 34 steps to just reduce the analysis time. I just used 34 steps, and the monitor displacement for my roof displacement was not 50 inches, it was 35 inches. And you can see here that the pushover curve is still going up, which means I should have pushed it up to a very large displacement until it reached to its peak number, and then start going down, right? But in order to reduce analysis time, I only push it up till 36 inches of roof displacement, but the curve is still going up. You can still see that there is several, you can say, several levels of nonlinearity which it have encountered, because initially it started as a straight line, but then it deviate from that straight line at certain levels of pushover steps, and you can guess that the certain elements will be yielding or cracking at different points on that pushover curve. Because of that, it is going in the nonlinear range. So you can actually see the hinge results also, and all other results also, but I want to show you graphically also. These two tables are actually the base shear versus roof displacement plot. You can copy that, take it to Excel and plot it yourself. Now let's see the damage of this building at different pushover steps. So I'll go to that 3D view again, and let me plot the deformed shape. And in the deformed shape, let me select the pushover mode 1 push case. Now I can go to a maximum of 35 or 36 steps, I think. Yeah, 34 steps, sorry. So I push it in 34 steps. So 34th step is my last step, right? So let me first start with the very first step of pushover analysis. So I select step number 1. The scaling is automatic, let's say, and let me select the hinge state color dots. I can show the color coding of different hinge results either in the form of points on the force deformation curve, which I give B, C, D and E points. B is the yield point, C is that ultimate, D is that these points are available in on any force deformation curve in E-tabs. But alternatively, I can also you can say color code different hinge results at each pushover stage based on the acceptance criteria which I give, which means that whatever IO value I give to any force deformation behavior in any plastic hinge or any fiber hinge, if it is before IO, it will give me with a different color. If it is between IO and life safety, it will be with a different color, and life safety and CP different color. So let's classify different hinge results at different pushover step cases in terms of IO, LS and CP, and I just click on apply. So this will give me a graphical depiction of different plastic hinges in my pushover case at stage number 1. So you can see here that black color means that you are even beyond before IO, and green means that you are IO and in between IO and LS. Basically, you are in at IO stage of performance level. I click on next here at the bottom, and you will see that more of the hinges which were black now becomes green. I go to, now this is step number 2 of 34, right? Then I go to next stage of pushover curve, and you can see here that more of the hinges join the green color. This is step 3. Now step 4. Step 4 is same, although the structure is being pushed more and more, but the no hinge has reached to the blue color now up till step 4. Then step 5, still no hinge in blue color. No, yes, there are some hinges which go to blue color now. Then step 6, some more hinges become blue. Step 7, now the hinges keep on increasing. Now at step number 8, there are few hinges which go to even red color, which means that at step number 8, they are at CP level. Step 8 will correspond to a certain level of roof displacement. So you can go back to your pushover curve and see the tabular form of pushover curve and see what is the roof displacement corresponding to step 8. Maybe it is corresponding to this peak number, right? Because let me see. Step 8 will correspond to what? Let me click on again this graph, this table option, and this table will show me what is the roof displacement at step number 8, and we can exactly identify the point on the pushover curve which corresponds to the formation of CP level hinges, the start of formation of CP level hinges. So let's wait for the table to come and then see the roof displacement corresponding to step 8. Actually, currently what I am doing is that I am plotting the complete pushover curve, and we haven't actually studied that method to determine the target displacement or performance point yet. Currently I am just showing you that at any step how you visualize the results, but actually when you calculate the target displacement or performance point, then you should focus only on that particular step, right? So that I will not be able to actually complete my initial presentation. I'll directly show you how ETABS implement those methods of calculating performance point right after this demonstration, and there we can then end this session. So at that eighth step, this is the monitor displacement 10 inches, right? So 10 inches and 2843 kip is the base shear corresponding to the very first formation of CP hinges, right? So I close and go to 10 inch, which means somewhere here, because this is 8 inches, this is 12 inches, which means somewhere here. So this is exactly where my cursor is. This is the point where actually the collapse prevention hinges start becoming, right? So I can exactly pinpoint that what actually happened at each step of pushover analysis by again going back and then continue. This is step number 8. I can keep on continuing, and I will see that with more push, more and more hinges are going to red color. And at the end, I think when I go to 34th step, several of the hinges will be in the red color. So let me directly go to here in this form. Let me directly type 34 and click on apply. It will give me the condition of the structure at the end of complete pushover curve, which means at the 34th step. So you can see already at the 16th step, you already have many of the hinges which are in red color. Some are column hinges, some may be shear wall hinges. So maybe 34, if I click and apply, you can see that majority of the hinges are already in the red color, right? So which means that if, for example, if I go back to the pushover curve now, if your future earthquake is going to produce a displacement, roof displacement of 36 inches, this is going to be the condition of your structure. It will be all completely CP level, right? And if it is less than 10 inches, if the future earthquake is going to produce a peak roof displacement of less than 10 inches, then your structure will have no collapse prevention plastic hinge, right? Because the first CP start at step number 8, corresponding to 10 inches displacement of roof, right? So that's how you will actually see, visualize the performance of the building in pushover analysis. You can always see the tabular results of each individual hinge by going to display, and then hinge results also visually you can see, and in the show tables you can see in the tabular form. I will go to, for example, hinge results here. In the hinge results case, you can see the results of an individual plastic hinge in the pushover case. So let me go to some fiber hinge, for example. Let me select the story 1 frame column, and let's say this is my fiber hinge, and let me select the individual fiber results option. This will give me the, let's say that fiber number 13 in this particular column was my concrete fiber, and this is my concrete stress strain curve. Now the red color is my curve which I give as an input, and blue color is the curve which actually is my demand curve. My applied loading of pushover have actually have taken my this concrete fiber up till this level in tension. The negative side is compression and positive side is tension. Negative is compression and positive is tension. So let me toggle between different pushover steps. So you can see that this dot is moving on my stress strain curve, which means that as I am pushing the structure more and more, step number 1 to step number 34, this particular concrete fiber is being stressed in tension side. So that is already, let me go back to step number, maybe this one. So this is cracked in tension already in the third step of pushover analysis, because it has already crossed the peak tensile capacity. So when I go to, let's say, step number 7 of pushover, the compression capacity is already overcome completely. So it is already in the flat line, right? So if I select any other fiber, for example, some other fiber, now this is fiber number 7 for the same column, and it is a steel fiber. And you can see that at step number 7, it is somewhere here. So it is far beyond before yielding, right? So if I go to more and more pushover steps, you can see that it is not moving more, right? So it is not yielding actually. So this particular steel fiber is not yielded under this pushover analysis. But you can select a certain other fiber which has yielded. You can see that the blue line will cross the yield point also in certain fibers, right? So these results can also be visualized in form of in the form of tables here in the display show tables option.